Good morning, students. Today we will start a very important topic of your syllabus, that is accounting from incomplete records. Now in our plus 2 level, plus as well as foundation, we have studied we have the habit of preparing financial statement, that is final account, from a complete trial balance given to you, right? So they give us the trial balance, and with the help of that trial balance we prepare final account, because trial balance basically it is prepared to check the arithmetical accuracy, whether from the journal the ledger has been prepared correctly or not. Further, it makes the task of preparing final account very easy, right? Because on the debit side you have asset and expenses, on the credit side you have liability and incomes. So if we are provided with trial balance, so our preparation of final account becomes very easy. So trial balance you will be only able to prepare when you maintain accounts under double entry system. Double entry system means for every transaction there are two aspects, receiving aspect and giving aspect. When you are recording the both aspects of the transaction, both the receiving aspect and giving aspect, it is known as double entry system. So under double entry system you prepare transaction, then ledger accounts, and then you find out the balance of each such ledger, and then you prepare trial balance, right? And with the help of that trial balance you prepare final account. So this is double entry system, right? Double entry of bookkeeping, we also call it as double entry system. Now what is this accounting from incomplete record? This is commonly known as, this chapter is commonly known as single entry system. Basically these are followed by organizations which are very small in size, those who cannot afford to keep an accountant to record day to day transactions, small traders, retailers. So they maintain incomplete set of recordings, such as they don't maintain, they don't record all transactions, right? They only keep record of few debtors and few creditors, that's it. They don't have any information with respect to what is your fixed asset, and they simply maintain few accounts, right? They will have details of some debtors, they will have details of creditors, further they will have some cash transaction details. So we will be provided data in an incomplete manner, and with the help of that we have to finalize accounts. So we can do it in two ways. There are two methods of doing accounting for incomplete record, right? One is statement of affairs method. There are two ways of finalizing accounts, right? One is statement of affairs method, and the second one is conversion method. So we will first talk about the conversion method, right? Step one, prepare various accounts to find out the missing figure, right? What we have to do, we have to prepare various accounts to find out the missing figure, and then we will prepare final account. Now this conversion method is very simple, right? We will be starting with this conversion method only initially, and then we will move on to the statement of affair method. Now what kind of information will be missing? I have told you that we maintain list of some debtors and creditors and few cash transactions. So there might be a case that you don't know the how much sales you have done. You have recording of cash, you know what is your cash position, right? But you don't know your cash sales during the year, right? Further, you might have your debtor balances, you might have amount received from collection, but you may not have credit sales figure. So in that case we know that in order to calculate credit sales we have to prepare debtors account, and from that debtors account we can get credit sales. Similarly is the case with supplier. In order to get credit purchase you have to prepare creditors account, and then accordingly you will get you will prepare creditors account, accordingly you will get credit purchase. Similarly if you don't have cash sales, you know what was your cash opening and you know the closing cash, you know all expenses and all. So remaining one will be your cash sales balancing figure from your cash account. So there are so many informations which you don't know. If you have the trial balance, In trial balance, they give us the full detail. Okay, this is the purchase for the year. This is the sale for the year. This was your closing cash. This was your capital. This was your drawings during the year. This was your fixed asset. This is your furniture. This is your expense. So all information you have, and with the help of that, you prepare final account. But here we have incomplete recorded. Now, incomplete means incomplete. The accounts are not complete. Some information is there, some information is not there. Now, what I am maintaining, that is not our matter of concern. What is available, that is our matter of concern. Some prepare only debtor and creditors ledger. Some prepare debtor creditors plus cash and bank. Some also maintain purchase day book, sale day book along with debtor and creditor. So in that case, you will find different types of problem where different types of figure will be missing, right? Different types of problem and different types of figure will be missing, and accordingly we have to calculate that and prepare final account. Is that fine? So what are the various accounts that we have to prepare? Just commonly I am telling you, we might have to prepare debtor's account, right? Then we might have to prepare creditor's account, then sometimes cash book, cash and bank. Then sometimes they might also ask you to prepare fixed asset account, right? So all these accounts we have to prepare, and something or the other we will get as balancing figure. Either we will get something as balancing figure, or I'll get some other data as balancing figure, right? That we will do whenever you do a problem. You will find that in one problem debtors have been prepared to calculate credit sale, but in another problem debtors have been prepared to calculate closing debtor. So it is not there is no universal rule that only okay, this is the missing, so you move like this. Okay, this is missing, you move like this. So you have the general knowledge of accounting, right? How to prepare journal, how to prepare ledger, what will be the journal entry for this, right? What will be the treatment for this? So accordingly you are going to apply that knowledge and find out what is required. Say for example, if they tell us to prepare trading account, and they have given us opening stock, closing stock. They have given us purchase and sale. So trading account is complete. I don't have to prepare any account because purchase and sale they have given. Some problem you will find that the debtors and the closing balance of debtor and closing balance of creditor is given. They have given collection, they have given payment. So now in order to prepare trading account, I have to prepare debtor and creditor so that I can get purchase and sale, right? So there are different types of problem, different types of data will be missing, and basically you have to see what you need, right, to prepare your final account. And accordingly, if that is available, you do not have to prepare account. If that is not available, you have to prepare accounts, right? So basically this chapter has no explanation, right? As of now, I cannot give you any set of rules. What we'll be doing, we'll be moving one after the another. What we'll be doing, we'll be doing many problems, right? And when you are done at least 20 to 25 problems, at the end of 20 problems, you will realize, okay, fine, since I have done so many problems, now a general sense have been developed. Okay, fine, this is moving, this is missing, so prepare this and get this, right? So you have to maintain that, right? So let us start, and we will do easy problems, and like that we will move to more difficult ones, right? So let us start question number one. So we are doing conversion method. Remember, keep in mind, we are doing only right now we are doing only conversion method, where we have to prepare various accounts to find out the missing figure. It can be debtors, it can be creditors, it can be cash book, it can be fixed asset, and whatever information is missing, we will calculate that. And once we calculate those missing figures, once we will straight away prepare trading PL and balance sheet, right? So whenever you read this type of problem, whenever you read accounting from incomplete record problem, you will find that the trial balance is not provided, right? So you will always find that trial balance is not provided, and they will ask what? Final account. So you know how to prepare final account in case of double entry system. In case of incomplete record, I am teaching you today, right? So first of all, we will do problem number one. Just read question number one. Right? Read question number one. right? So you can see that they have told us to find out the total sales and the total purchase, right? This is simply a small extract of the main problem. They have given us debtors opening and closing opening balance, creditors opening balance, bills receivable received during the year, bills payable issued during the year, cash received, cash paid, bad debt recovered, bills receivable endorsed to creditor, bills receivable dishonored by customer, okay, discount allowed to by supplier, discount allowed to customer, endorsed bill dishonored, sales return, bills receivable discounted, bills receivable discounted dishonored, cash sales, cash purchases, closing debtor, closing creditor. Now this is something really very important, and we have done it in many cases. In foundation we had that bill of exchange chapter, right? And further in lot of cases we have prepared this debtors and creditor where we have this information, right? Self balancing, there was one chapter called self balancing ledger system, right? So in that we had the concept of, we know how to prepare debtors and creditors account. So let us start. We will be preparing total debtors account. Is that fine? Okay. Now debtors have debit balance, creditors have credit balance. Two balance brought down. Creditors opening balance will be on the credit side. Then we have bills receivable received, so debtors will decrease. So by bills receivable, ₹47,000, right? Bills payable issued, so creditors will decrease. Bills receivable means I have drawn, my customer has accepted, and bills payable means my supplier has drawn and I have accepted. Cash received from customer, again my debtor will decrease. Buy cash, 1,56,000. Simple. You know how to prepare. If there is a decrease in debtor, it will be credited. If there is an increase, it will be debited. Similarly, creditor increase will be credited, decrease will be debited. So it is 1,56,000. And cash paid to creditor, again it is creditor to cash, so creditor's account debit 1,72,000. Now bad debt recover, it will be directly credited to profit and loss account. So bad debt recovery entries is cash account debit to bad debt recovery. Note, bad debt recovery is treated as indirect income. Bad debt recovery means that debtor is not there in my books. I have shown it as bad. So entry will be cash account debit to bad debt recovery. Right, so my debtors is not affected. Debtors account is not affected. Right now, bills receivable endorsed to creditor. So instead of accepting the false fresh bill drawn by the supplier, I will give him my bills receivable. So creditor will decrease again 27,000. Right? So out of 47,000 bill, I have endorsed bill of 27,000. So my creditor will decrease. Now bills receivable dishonored by customer. Now out of bills receivable, again 5,000 has been dishonored. So I will 2BR dishonored. I will increase my debtor balance. When they accepted and gave me the bill, in that case I decrease my debtor. Now it has been dishonored, so now I will increase it. Discount allowed by supplier is discount received. So my creditor's account will decrease 7,000. And allowed to customer is discount allowed, so my debtors will decrease. So by discount allowed 9,000. Is that fine, everyone? I guess there should not be any problem with respect to this. Endorsed bill dishonor. Now my creditor will charge me and I will charge my debtor. So as a result of which my debtor and creditor both will increase. So in debtor I will write two creditors. It is a contra entry. I'll write endorsed BR dishonored, only 3,000, not whole. And in creditor I will write by debtors endorsed BR dishonored. Right, sales return 11,000. So my debtors will decrease. BR discounted, bills receivable discounted, right? So I have discounted with the bank, right? So that is bank account debit, discount account debit to BR. So neither my debtor nor my creditor is affected. Okay. Discounted bill dishonored. Now bank will charge when I will charge my debtor. So I'll write to bank dishonor. Right, debtor will increase by 2,000. Okay. Fine. So cash sales and cash purchase won't come here, right? It will come directly when I calculate total sales indirectly in trading account. So the closing balance of debtor is 82,000 and closing balance of creditor is 95,000. So automatically I will get two sales balancing figure and here I will get buy purchases balancing figure, and this is credit sale and credit purchase, remember? So now I'll calculate. So it is like 47,000 plus 1,56,000 plus 9,000 plus 11,000 plus 82 minus 70 minus 5 minus 3 minus 2. Right? So it is coming to 2,25,000. एंड परचेज इट इज 53 प्लस 1,72,000 प्लस 27,000 प्लस 7,000 प्लस 95, दैट कम्स टू 3,54,000 माइनस 81 माइनस 3,000, सो इट इज कमिंग टू 2,70,000. सो दिस इज आई हैव गॉट माई क्रेडिट सेल एंड क्रेडिट परचेजेस. इज दैट फाइन? Done. Now, what they have asked us? They have asked us the total sales. So total sales is what? Cash sales plus credit sales. So cash sales is rupees 1,68,500. Plus 2,25,000, right? So 1,68,500 this is credit to trading account, and don't forget to do less return because they have asked us total sales, but in trading account net sales is credited. Similarly, I'll calculate total purchases, that is cash purchases plus credit purchases. So cash purchases 197 Is that fine? Right, so like this they will give us information so that we will be able to prepare our debtor and creditors. So debtors we got credit sale, we will add cash sales and then put it on the credit trading account, and similarly we will do for purchases, right? So this is accounting from incomplete record, right? They have given us few informations, and with the help of that, the only information which is missing is credit sales and credit purchase. In case of double entry system, no problem. I record each and every transaction. So every transaction, two aspect is getting recorded, that is getting summarized in ledger, and ultimately we get know the net summarized balance. But here in this case, we are maintaining only debtors and creditors list. Okay, fine, this much is due as of today. This much has been received. So sales is the balancing figure, right? Okay, fine. So now we'll be doing problem number two. They have given us a balance sheet on 1st April, right? Now what they are saying, just listen to it very carefully. Just read it, you will get it very easily. They have given us a balance sheet on 1st April. Capital is 10 lakh, okay. Creditors is trade creditors, 1 lakh 40. Profit and loss account is 60. Fixed asset is 4 lakh, stock is 3 lakh, debtor is 1 lakh 50. And cash and bank is 3 lakh 50. Management estimates the purchase and sale for the year ended. This is for the coming year, right? So automatically this becomes the opening balance sheet. Purchase up to February is 14 lakh 10, and March it is 1 lakh 10. Similarly, sales, it is means from April to Feb, for first 11 months purchase sale is given separately, and last one sale is given separately. It was decided to invest 1 lakh in purchase of fixed asset. Fine enough, we have purchased a fixed asset which will be depreciated at the rate of 10% on cost. Time lag for payment to creditor for purchase and receipt from sale is 1 month. Okay, fine. Business earns a profit of 30% on turnover. Sundry expenses excluding depreciation works out to 10% of turnover. Draft a balance sheet as at 31st March, assuming that creditors are all trade creditors, means goods wala, and debtors are all trade debtors, that is goods wala, right? And there is no other item of current asset, current liability apart from stock and cash and bank balance. So apart from debtor and current creditors, we don't have any other current asset, current liability. That is clearly evident from the opening balance sheet as well. So what we have to prepare, draft a balance sheet, they have told us. Okay, fine. So now you can easily see that in order to draft the balance sheet, I need to have the net profit, because that net profit will be carried forward to the balance sheet. Yes or no? So in order to draft the balance sheet as of 31st March, I need to prepare the net profit, trading and PL. Okay. So what we'll be doing, that is clear, na? That in order to draft the balance sheet, I have to prepare trading end, because they have not given us net profit or loss. They have given us things in a paragraph form, and we have to find out, right? So basically, we have to use the knowledge of ratio analysis, which is there in our financial management paper, as well as we have studied in plus two, right? So basically, it will be regarded as, first of all, they have told us to draft a balance sheet, okay, fine. So that balance sheet I can draw, but I have to find out the net profit for the year, because net profit will be added to the capital, and accordingly we'll get the closing capital, right? So note number one, we have to prepare projected trading and PL account for the year ended 31st March Is that fine? Okay. Now, many information they have given us. They have given us opening stock. So two stock is 3 lakh. From the opening balance sheet, I can get. Two purchases by sales by closing stock. So I have two gross profit. Right, then PL we have sundry expenses, then we have two depreciation, and we don't have any other item, right? So ultimately, we get the net profit. Is that fine? Because they have told us, see, what is our required information? They have told us to prepare the balance sheet. So for closing balance sheet, we need the net profit. If I would have told you that capital is, say, 10 lakh, say, for example, that I have told you that opening capital, 10 lakh, and during the year, your profit is 6 lakh. So what is your closing capital? You can easily say, it is 16 lakh. But here, will you be able to say that? No, because you don't know this net profit. So first of all, you have to prepare this. And that can only be prepared by preparing trading NPL. Right? So initially, we have to prepare the profit and loss account. Then only we can prepare and the closing balance sheet, right? Because until unless we prepare this, we will not be able to find out. Okay. Now, is that fine? So now, in order to complete this, what informations we have, we will put it, and then the remaining one we will see later. So we know the opening stock that is there in opening balance sheet. Purchase, I know, right? They have given us it is 14 lakh 10 plus 1 lakh 10, right? So that comes to 15 lakh 20. Similarly, sales also they have given us. It's 19 lakh 20 plus 2 lakh. So that comes to 21 lakh 20. Right? So now, they have given us gross profit 30%. So gross profit is what? 30% of 21 lakh 20,000. Six lakh 36,000. Right. In our plus two level and foundation level, we have done this. We have the purchase, sale, opening stock, GP. So we get closing stock as balancing figure. Now, it serves the two purpose. Anyway, we need net profit for closing balance sheet, I showed you. Further, we also needed closing stock. So you can see that I'm getting closing stock as balancing figures. So we thought of preparing this trading PL for the purpose of getting net profit. But later on, I also realized that I need closing stock also prepare the closing balance sheet. So that also I got it. So apne in Hindi, we call it as ek teer do nishana, right? So we thought of doing it from one way, but it served the other purpose as well, right? So closing stock as balancing figure, how much? This will help us to prepare the balance sheet. Right, how much is it? 3,36,000. Is that fine? So we have the opening, we have the purchase, we have the sale during the year. I'll add take the total sale. We have closing stock, we have this thing, we have the gross profit. The closing stock we got as balancing figure. Now we'll bring down gross profit to the PL account. Now sundry expenses is 10% of turnover, right? So that is like 21,20,000 into 10%. So that comes to 2,12,000. Similarly, I will have depreciation. I can calculate in note number one because things will become clumsy out here, right? So basically, they are telling 10% on cost. So already, so depreciation will be like 4 lakh was already there and 1 lakh I purchased and 10% is the rate. So opening plus purchase total is 5 lakh into 10%, 50,000 is my depreciation. Right. So 6,36,000 minus 2,12,000 minus 50,000. Right? So that comes to 3,74,000, right? So here I will take two things. One is the closing stock will help us to prepare the balance sheet, and this net profit was our intention. We got double purpose served. Is that fine? Right? So we had the opening stock, we have purchases, right? I'm repeating it again and again so that it becomes easy for you to understand. We have purchase, we have sales, we have the gross profit. So this trading part, we have done it many times in the past in our foundations level, right? Inventory chapter was there, right? We know the opening, purchase, sales. So what will be the closing stock provided the GP percentage given, right? Now that profit has been transferred to PL and sales 10% is sundry expenses. We have calculated depreciation, so remaining is net profit, right? Now, the main part of the problem, that is the balance sheet. Now, that is very simple. Now see, already we have capital how much? 10 lakhs. So it will be same, because here the company has the practice of treating net profit separately. What is PL account opening balance? 60. Add net profit 3,74,000. Sorry, if this is note number 1, so this will be note 2. Here it will be note 2, right? So that comes to 4,00,000. Right? 4,34,000. Now, what will be the creditors? Creditors is usually 1 month lag. So opening the lag was 1,40,000. So if the lag is 1 month opening creditor, it means this creditor was for March last year. Now during the year, till Feb, the purchase is 14,10,000. And March 1, the purchase is 1,10,000. So what is my closing creditor? Again, the lag will be 1 month. Yes or no? This is very simple. Again, the lag will be 1 month. It means whatever purchase was done in the month of March, that has not been paid. Yes or no? This concept is purely of ratio analysis. Opening creditor was for the month of March last year. 1 month they have told. So similarly, this year closing creditor will be this year's March purchase. So they have given us. Had they would have given us for full year, we would have calculated monthly. We would have assumed evenly purchased throughout the year. Then in that case, we would have divided by 12 and we would have got purchase for the month of March. But in this case, they haven't given us for full year. They have given it month wise. So March month will be my closing creditor. March month's purchase, right? 1 month. So with the help of that, I can easily say that, let us make it note 3. Like this also you can explain in problem exam. So with the help of this, it is 1,10,000. 1 month purchase is outstanding. Is that fine? Okay. So that is successfully I have completed the liability side. Now, with respect to fixed asset, already we had 4,00,000. Add additions 1,00,000. So the total is 5,00,000. Less 4,50,000 is my fixed asset figure. Now, closing stock already I got by preparing PL. Right. Debtor concept is same as creditor. So 1 month, see March month sale is outstanding. Now cash and bank I don't have. So for this I have to prepare cash and bank. Are you getting my point? First of all, you have to move what we need. And I have told you in the past also that what they will ask you in the problem, that should be kept in the front. So PL and balance sheet is the main part. So I'm preparing. I'm getting stuck. Think. Right? So in this problem, there was nothing. Each and every information was given except cash and bank. Right? Closing stock was missing. So I already got it when I prepared trading PL. I prepared trading PL with the objective of getting net profit, but double purpose served. Now I'm easily preparing balance sheet, I'm not getting stuck, but at the last I got stuck. Right? So now I will open one cash and bank ledger. So what is the opening balance? ₹3,50,000. Now tell me what transactions might have taken. Just move slowly. With respect to capital, there is no further capital, no drawings. Fine. With respect to fixed asset, there is purchase of 1 lakh. Right, depreciation is non-cash. With respect to goods, there is payment to creditor, collection from debtor and payment of expenses. So by creditors, by expenses, to debtors, right? Now listen to me very carefully. In order to get expense payment, that is very easy, because in PL how much I have shown? 2,12,000, and we know the concept of cash flow. If there is no outstanding prepaid, it means the amount paid is 2,12,000. With respect to debtor and creditor, things are very easy. The opening creditor is belong to last year March purchase, so that has been paid, and this year only March is outstanding. It means till February it is paid. So opening is paid plus purchase till February is paid, because at the end only March is outstanding, 1 month. So April you pay March like this. You can see that opening is paid out, because at the end only 1 month is outstanding, that is current year March is outstanding at the end of March. Means till February everything has been paid and opening has been paid. So paid. So total payment to creditor is 1,40,000 opening, प्लस 14 लाख 10, इट इज परचेज टिल फरवरी. अदरवाइज वी इफ इफ दे वुड नॉट हैव गिवन अस डाटाज लाइक दिस, इन दैट केस वी वुड हैव प्रिपेयर्ड क्रेडिटर्स अकाउंट. सो हियर प्रॉब्लम नंबर वन, आई प्रिपेयर डेटर एंड क्रेडिटर टू कैलकुलेट क्रेडिट सेल एंड क्रेडिट परचेज, बट इन दिस प्रॉब्लम आई एम प्रिपेयरिंग डेटर एंड क्रेडिटर टू कैलकुलेट दिस पेमेंट एंड कलेक्शन सो दैट आई कैन कंप्लीट कैश अकाउंट. आई टोल्ड यू डिफरेंट अकाउंट विल बी प्रिपेयर फॉर डिफरेंट पर्पज एट डिफरेंट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. लास्ट सम आई प्रिपेयर डेटर क्रेडिटर टू कैलकुलेट क्रेडिट सेल क्रेडिट परचेज, बट हियर आई एम गेटिंग क्रेडिटर्स अकाउंट फॉर पेमेंट एंड डेटर अकाउंट फॉर कलेक्शन, बिकॉज परचेज सेल वी नो, क्लोजिंग डेटर वी नो, दिस इज मिसिंग, राइट. सो 140 प्लस 14 लाख 10, हाउ मच इट इज 15 लाख 50,000, राइट. सो सिमिलरली आई विल डू इट डेटर्स अकाउंट. ओपनिंग डेटर इज हाउ मच, सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू गेट क्लोजिंग कैश एज बैलेंसिंग फिगर. फाइव लैख 58. सिंस वी नो द पेमेंट, दैट इज वाई वी आर नॉट प्रिपेयरिंग. द पेमेंट इज वेरी क्लियर, ओनली मार्च इज आउटस्टैंडिंग, इट मीन्स दिस हैज बीन पेड. ओपनिंग प्लस परचेज टिल फेब एंड ओपनिंग डेटर प्लस सेल टिल फेब इज कलेक्टेड. If they would not have given this details month wise, in that case we would have prepared debtor and creditor. We'll do one problem, right, and I'll make you understand, right. So what was my flow chart for balance sheet preparation? This was one was my main. I have to prepare balance sheet. First we prepared PL and it served dual purpose. Closing stock calculated, right? Then debtors closing and creditors closing was easy. Then cash and bank. Now for this cash and bank, I have to prepare debtors account and creditors account. Paid, sorry, from debtors collection and from creditors payment. This will be posted and then cash balance will be calculated. So basically this is the flow chart. Our main purpose was to prepare PL and balance sheet. So PLI prepared, automatically I got closing stock for balance sheet. Debtor closing and creditor closing I got it easily. Now I need cash and bank. So for that I have to prepare debtor and creditor account. Debtors will give me collection and creditors will give me payment. But here I have not prepared because it is very easy. Right? So this is the flow chart which is not universal in all the problems. There will be here and there, right? And time to time when you practice sums a lot, you will automatically get it. So now I will put it instead of this question mark, which I'm going to delete. It is 5,58,000. Now you see the balance sheet total. How much? 15,44,000. 15,44,000. And just do the asset side. It is 4,50,000 plus 3,36,000 plus 2,00,000 plus 5,58,000. Ten on ten, right? So, like this, we are going to do, right? In our next class, we'll be taking up few more problems, right? This chapter will go on for practice, 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 and you can also try question number 3, 4, and 5 at home. And next class, we'll be again taking those questions, right? So thank you so much. Bye-bye.